And welcome to Utah Business Matters, your weekly television window to small business in the state of Utah. And we begin today with marketing and branding. We are all social by nature, but is social nature your marketing and branding company? Michael Reagan hopes that it will be.
I remember waking up one morning, and I remember this very vividly, and I had said to my wife, would you mind if I tried to go into business for myself? And her, being the amazing person that she was, said, you do whatever's going to make you happy. So with not a lot of money in my pocket and not a lot of money in savings, I went ahead and took that leap of faith and went ahead and started my own company, a marketing company. I also have broadcast experience. I've been on the radio with KSL for many years, for the last 15 years actually, so I've learned quite a bit from that particular end of the business also. So I kind of took all that experience and I thought, I'm going to go after that segment of the market of people that need marketing help but can't really afford it. And one of my clients, my earliest clients, is Oreck Vacuums, and I'm still consulting with them to this day. And they've been a great client and we've had a great relationship thus far. I would help them out with some of their marketing messages. I'd help other companies out with creating PR campaigns, POP materials, all sorts of different things, branding, making sure that their message is heard. I really don't think there is such thing as a social media expert, because the whole field is evolving and changing so fast and so dynamically that you really can't be an expert. Trying to be your own one-man show gets a little tiring, gets a little difficult, because you're promoting yourself, you're promoting your company, you're working, you're having to do the financials, you're having to do the bookkeeping, you're having to go out and find business. It's just, I mean, it's daunting. I've known my partner Nick for over a couple of years now.
I was from Las Vegas and worked for M&M Mars, and for family reasons decided to move up here.
And it was in October of last year that I asked him if he would please consider coming on board with me, and we'd partner together.
M&M's sell billions of candies a day, and I helped spur that along. And it definitely added a lot to what I know now and what I can bring to other businesses. I know how the billionaires do it.
It's been a fantastic partnership ever since. Nick has a knowledge of marketing unlike anyone I've ever known.
The very first thing is meeting the client and finding out who they are, what they're currently doing, what their products are, who their customers are, who they want their customers to be. Then it's coming up with, you know, what are their aspirations, short term and long term, and of course, what kind of investment are they looking to put into it.
Still, a lot of companies will think that they have the insight to be able to do it on their own, and they really don't have the time to do it, and that's where we come in to kind of try and help them out with saying, hey, let us take that burden off of you and help you out with your marketing proposal and marketing plan. Social media is now just a portion of the overall picture, whereas now we're focusing more on helping people develop their products, developing their message, and then developing a platform that they can market their products with. As I like to say, we can do everything a large agency can do with just a lot less zeros on the end of the bill. Our motto is, it's because we're social by nature. So I was thinking social, and then I was thinking media, and then I was thinking, social nature, and then that's kind of where the name just kind of popped in. We like to help out the smaller business and the mid-sized businesses because of the fact that they're as passionate about their product or their business as we're passionate about ours. There are certain clients that Nick will work primarily with, such as the Mayor of Murray created a novelty button that Nick has been the primary person on that.
Michael has met Mayor Snar a number of times and he said, I need some help. I invented the sucks button.
And anything is possible with the Snarco sucks button.
Well, that totally sucks.
Nick developed the packaging for it, developed the marketing plan, has gone to trade shows with it and everything, and has done just a phenomenal job with it.
Some people, you know, immediately get it, and some of them, it takes them a second to like, you know, well, why would I want a button to be negative? And the reality is it's not negative. It's just, you have those moments in the day where you just kind of throw your arms up in the air, and rather than just letting it take you down, the button reminds you. It's like, just suck it up.
So we'll just kind of take each project as it comes in, and we'll say, okay, what about this turns you on, and what about that turns you on, and we'll just kind of start dividing it up and going from there. My partner and I have managed to keep this thing going now for 4 years in the worst economic times of our lifetimes. And I figure if we can keep it going through this, then the sky's the limit when everything turns around and everybody's wanting to do things again. Mobile marketing is becoming even bigger now than what it ever used to be. So what we have created is something called Compass, and it's basically our texting platform that we created that it's really low cost, and it enables a business to actually sign up for the service, and we help them literally go from beginning to implementation with getting their message out there via text marketing. All it basically will be is that, you know something, I'm anticipating a slow day this week, you send off a message to us or you pick up the phone and say, I need a campaign set up, and we take care of it for you automatically, and that's all there is to it.
That's what social media is. It's making a connection with people. It's all about being social and having a relationship with your customers. That's a huge thing when people talk about, you know, I don't have a lot of customers, and they think, well, it's the economy. It's like, well, does anybody actually know you're here?
It's been one heck of a ride as far as what I've learned. I've learned so much, and I've met so many amazing people being self-employed and developing my company with my partner than I could have ever hoped for working for somebody else.
I knew it was gonna be absolutely, you know, almost a vow of poverty and a journey that you've gotta take. You know, choosing to go that route and working for yourself, knowing that every paycheck is going to be the direct correlation of your actions. I definitely didn't have any notions of wealth or wonders. I just knew I wanted to devote time and effort into something that made me feel good.
Eventually, what we'd like to see is to have a great office that we can have a whole bunch of people just collaborating together in an open environment that we can all share and develop, and again, help the smaller person. We're not out to help the gigantic brands as much as we'd like to. We're passionate about helping the smaller individual, the smaller businesses, and even the mid-sized businesses, but it's just, we have the passion and we care enough that we can take whatever passion that a client of ours might have and take on that passion also and help them develop the message and make them also the success that they want to be.